It has everything. Bumping and banging.
Big Boy Big Neighborhood.
All righty, man. And I got all legendary up in here, ladies and gentlemen. DJ Pooh is in the neighborhood, man. Yeah. Grow House, the movie, in theaters. Make sure y'all go check that out. And also Lil Duval. What's going on, brother?
What's up, OG?
Man, let me tell you, brother. Sometimes I get nervous seeing you.
Why?
You know, because you always, even last night when I saw you at the premiere, you know, you're like, Big Boy, you know what I'm saying? But, man, I see you on Instagram sometime and Twitter. Bro, you got no pullback.
None at all, bro.
That's what a comedian's supposed to be, right?
Man, I guess so, man.
You're supposed to say what's on your mind and see what people feeling.
Duval, I saw one of the coldest from you, though, man.
What I did this time.
I don't even know. I think I'll say it in the break. And then if you wanted me to say it on air.
Go ahead and say it, man. I don't care.
You sure?
I'm positive.
It was, man, it was cold.
I don't care.
I don't know if you've been following them for a while, Pooh, but Tina Marie died. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And it was like, damn, Tina Marie died. Tina Marie. And for those who don't know, man, like Tina Marie, dope singers, songs, just legend. Legendary. Do you remember the tweet that you put out?
Which I think
because everybody was like, I think she died. I heard something.
I think I said, is she dead? I don't know what
he
I
put
said.
At Tina Marie, he asked her. He said, "At Tina Marie, are you dead?"
Wow.
Wait. In my defense, at that time they was faking a lot of deaths on Twitter.
Yeah,
everybody was like, "Oh, this person dead." They said Bill Cosby was dead. They said all these people was dead. Yeah. So I said, "Well, let me ask and see if she dead."
Right. Okay. All right. When you explain it,
what do you do in real life when somebody say somebody? Don't you call?
You call them? Yeah, man. Yeah.
That's what I did.
And Duval, you be like, "Man, please, God, answer the phone, man. Answer the phone."
See, and a lot of time, like in that social media, I've been in this game for a long, especially social media. It's been normal to me for a long time. It's just new to y'all. Like, now it's obvious now. But back then, how y'all feel about social media now, that's how I felt then. So, in my mind, I was actually talking to her.
Oh.
You see what I'm saying? I was like, hey, man, is you dead?
Right.
Somebody on the phone. Right. So, that's how it was.
Yeah,
so
it's a little different when they're dead, though, Duval. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? It's just a little different.
I forgot. I was like, hold up.
It's definitely hard to answer.
Honestly, on everything, rest in peace, Pimp C. I called him. When they said he was out, I was like, let me call and see if he dead. He never picked up. So I said, uh-oh.
Right.
You see what I'm saying?
It happens. I know when I hear stories, I call the person or you're tempted to call them.
So really, I was the only normal person.
To be real.
Yeah,
but
man.
If you don't get that answer, that boy.
Yeah, man.
She didn't reply.
All
right,
well, we got that out the way. All right, but Pooh, we are back in the theaters, man.
I'm glad we
got
that.
Did you see how he transitioned to that?
Yeah.
So enough about that, Pooh.
Yeah. So Pooh, talk to me, man. Now, Grow House is in theaters now.
Yes.
But it's been a mission getting this movie to the screen.
It has been.
It's a good thing that everybody continuity looked the same.
It took so long, bro. I thought he was waiting on me to die or something.
Right. So that good release.
Yeah.
Then I would have been like, Duval, you dead?
Yeah. On some rapper stuff, you know, they put rappers' music out after they die. So I was like, maybe that's what he's trying to do to me.
Trying to wait me out.
Yeah.
Then you start thinking, is he gonna kill?
Yeah. I'm like, Pooh, is everything cool?
Man,
did I do anything?
But so, like,
don't give
y'all
no ideas for part two.
Y'all started the script like 5 years ago.
Yeah.
And y'all, and it was done. The movie's been done for about 3 years.
Yes.
Really?
But it doesn't. It's not dated. I don't know if you had to go in and try to do some re-edits or anything. But it's nothing dated.
It really survived. You know, time, man.
Yeah,
because
man.
I think everything is kind of coming around to it. I think we kind of got out ahead on the cannabis tip too.
And
it's just everything is coming around, so it's like perfect timing now.
And you see it, man. Like with, and I don't want to get the movie away, but with the cards, just everything. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like everything fell into pocket where you don't look and say,
because
like,
it's a real story too. Like if you want to open up a grow house, you can watch this movie and figure it out.
Yeah. I don't even want to open one, but I was like, damn, that looks simple.
Yeah.
That's what I like about the movie too. It's a comedy, but it's a realistic comedy. It's like that's what made Friday a classic because it was a real story with funny people in it. It wasn't like written to be jokey. It was written as a real story. You just had funny people in it. Mm-hmm.
And you attach yourself to the characters too.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like I think that the characters were very defined.
Yeah.
And the casting was amazing too, man. Yeah. And I don't want to give the movie away, but I enjoyed watching the movie. You know, but Pooh, what took it so long to get on the screen?
You know, it was crazy, man. We went through a period of, you know, we set out to make this film independently, first off. And when making a film independently, man, it's a lot of hurdles, man, that you got to jump over, man, you know, just to get the film out. And then especially when you're making a film about cannabis. And one thing I learned is, like, you can make a film about blowing up the White House, killing the president, eating babies, cooking meth, but God forbid you throw some weed leaves in the film.
Right. And, you know, it's a problem.
And so, yeah. So, you know, it was kind of learning a little bit about the hypocrisy in the game, man, and just learning how to deal with things. And work around it, man. But at the end of the day, I think everything happens for a
reason. Did you ever think, like, it wasn't going to come out, or you ever got pooh frustrated enough where you was like, man.
You know, I just did, watch but it at I never house. Give up, man. I never I give up that. On nothing, man. And you know, once I put my mind to it and said I'm going to do it, then I'm going to do it, no matter what it is. You know, a record, a video game, a film, or whatever.
Yeah. Speaking of video games, you're the one who got me in that Grand Theft Auto.
That's hella dumb, man. You know what I'm saying?
Man, you made me look like a genius, man. You killed
no,
it, man.
No, you made me look like a genius.
But I got to say, your station can't mess with mine, man. West Coast Classics.
Oh, yeah. Yours is banging. You knew which one to put me on. You know what I'm saying?
I stole your shine.
You could have put me in West Coast Classics, too. You know what I'm saying? It's all gravy, man. Now, with being in the franchise as well, man, just when we think about DJ Pooh, everybody think of Friday.
Yes.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? And you don't want to say, oh, this is the new. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know, because you created that along with Cube, and I don't know who else, but this is a different creation of, I think that we got a franchise here as well.
Oh, man, I sure hope so, man, because I really love working
and
with Duvall and D-Ray.
And the chemistry with Duvall and D-Ray, is there.
Man. Yes. I want to just give a shout out to him, because to me, he like the Martin Scorsese. How you say the dude's
name?
Scorsese.
You might want to learn his name.
Have it your way.
I ain't got to learn. I know Pooh. So
right, yeah. You know what I'm saying? He good in the hood.
Yeah, like, but just like for every movie he's touched been classic.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
and that's
man.
How I feel with this. I mean, I don't want to toot it yet because you don't want to put so much expectation on it. But I just, when we was in there last night, it just felt like a moment. You know what I'm saying? Like,
so
everybody
good.
Was
man, that was the fun-ass premiere.
Yeah, it was, man.
That thing felt like legendary.
And it
like
immediately starts smelling like smoke.
Oh, my
like,
goodness.
Yeah, man. As soon as the lights went down.
Yeah.
And on the real, man, Dog is my partner. When they was trying to see me, they said, well, do you want to sit with Snoop? And I was like, nah.
Like, better, hey,
oh, man. Because,
it didn't matter the way you said, though.
No, not at all.
You was going to get high.
It seemed like soon as the credit, like you said, Duvall, soon as the lights went off,
the smoke
everybody
went
lit up. I'm like, man. Good Lord, have mercy.
And it brought people together. You had white people, black people, Asians, Mexicans.
It was crazy.
All smoking past the J's.
Let me tell you the funniest thing.
Everybody was passing the J's up and down the road.
And the green carpet was fitting.
Oh, yeah, man.
Perfect.
Duvall, I was walking out, and it was some Caucasian older gentlemen in front of me.
Yeah.
And they were like, and I'm ear hustling in their conversation.
Yeah.
And they were like, oh, that was so good. I didn't expect that. You know, they just have a conversation. And then my man said, and the little guy, he was great.
You did amazing.
He was great. You know what I'm saying?
The Chris Rock looking guy.
He's like, oh my God.
White people love to say I look like Chris Rock.
Really though?
Yeah, I don't look nothing like him. But to white people, you look like anybody that be close to a black person they know.
Oh my God, Chris Rock. Look at this. You should have saw when I was big. I was every big person.
I know you was B.I.G.
Oh, Notorious B.I.G. I was Ruben Studdard from American Idol.
Big you know what I'm saying? You ain't even
like Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, man. Barry White. Like, Barry dead, man.
Anybody with a goatee.
Oh,
anybody
really?
With a goatee. Teddy Riley, all of them.
Do you get mistaken for cats for real?
Yes. Somebody told me I was Kevin Hart. I was like, come on, Matt, come on. I ain't that ugly.
Right, yeah. Oh,
Kevin Hart.
Come on, man.
You're like, I ain't that ugly, is there comedy beefs that go down, Duvall?
Not with me. Well, me and Kev, actually.
No, not Kev.
Oh, no, not that I know of, because I don't be around comedians like that.
Another. I heard
and
that.
The ones I do be around, they be on the road with me, like my man Jay Ski. If you follow me on social media, he my man that I take on the road with me all the time, and we all do shows together. Yeah. So I don't even have time to be around other comedians unless I know them. Like D-Ray, me and D-Ray, that's why our chemistry was so good, because we always do shows together, and he understand my comedy, and I understand him. And we don't try to outdo each other. You
hey,
know
man,
what I'm
I was about to say something just like y'all fit each other very well.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Don't say it too much, because that sounds almost like we gay.
Y'all together?
Like
y'all together?
Fit each other like
no,
that.
I don't think it should have sounded like that. Unless it's something you want to tell us.
No, ain't nothing with
yeah, I mean,
but,
he ran with
no,
that.
No, but dude. I know how the blogs are. The blogs will put in that they fit together, edit all the other stuff out, and next thing you know, we go together.
Wait, I'm just doing take that part right there.
Pretty much.
That's the part I'm going to edit. We go together.
Did you already? Did the cast have to audition for their roles, or did you already have everybody in mind for a specific role?
I had some specific people in mind, and then others came in and auditioned. But did Duvall tell y'all about?
Did I tell you how I met him?
Tell us.
Uh oh.
On MySpace.
Really?
How in the hell?
On MySpace, man. 10 years ago on MySpace, he hit me up and said, "Man, I got this movie, and I think you're funny as hell, man. I want to do it with you." So I'm like, "All right, cool." Like, I mean, it's poo, but I'm like, "This MySpace, dude. Ain't anybody
lying."
Right. You know what I'm saying? And from there, I kept in contact with him. He kept his word, and 5 years later, he's like, "I'm ready." Boom, boom, and here we are now.
Wow. Yeah. That's amazing.
And that's how it was, for real. Like, it was good. Actually, I don't know if you want me to tell, but he actually had it written for me and T.I.
Oh, really? No.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Originally, yeah.
It was going to be me and T.I. on the thing.
Damn.
I couldn't get T.I., though.
Yeah, yeah.
Man, but D-Ray did D-Ray that.
Killed him.
Man, I'm so happy I got D-Ray.
Oh, man. Was there any? What if you didn't get D-Ray?
Oh, man, I don't know what I would have done in that place, man.
Damn.
You know, I had a lot of options, but, they were options in case I couldn't get
yeah,
D-Ray.
Yeah, man, perfect combo.
Yeah. I had some backups because D-Ray had some other stuff going on, it was something he wanted to do, man. He worked it out.
It's a perfect movie for him. He helped me out a lot, just the time. Who? D-Ray?
D-Ray, because, I mean, like, this is my first real lead, for real.
Dude, let me tell you, Duvall, you did that very well.
Yeah. It was because of him and D-Ray, for real. Yeah, you know
D-Ray,
what I'm saying?
D-Ray is a true pro, man. I mean,
and he made it look like I can act, for real. Like,
Faison,
man, you did your thing, Duvall.
Hey, dude,
Faison's character.
Faison funny as hell.
Bro.
He just funny. Like, that's Faison funny.
So much.
Yeah, man. Y'all. Yeah. And see, even with that, you know, like, when Faison came on, his name came on, everybody started applauding and everything.
Life.
And you got to think how everything just fall into order with him snatching dude up at the airport over there.
Everything was perfect. When he did that snatch that dude up,
you was like,
I took it and put Grow House in theaters 420.
Yeah,
I said, hey, this is going to work for us.
You had no problem with that, huh?
Man, I ain't had no problem.
Hell no.
Like, I told him to slap me in press.
Yeah.
Like, we need this to go viral.
Like this is it, brother. This is the goal.
I'm trying to go viral.
Like, besides Pooh trying to wake my life out.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's when you're like, damn, why wasn't he wearing that Grow House shirt?
We didn't have no Grow House jacket for Faison. We didn't snatch that dude around like that.
I know how. We need something to go viral. Like, I'm thinking of something.
We got some shirts for him to wear to court, though.
Okay.
Oh, there it is. Does he have a court date like today or tomorrow?
Yeah, that's perfect timing.
That would be.
We got it. We got it.
You gonna wear that for real?
Duvall, do you smoke?
I just started smoking.
That damn movie.
Now you know what's so funny? I just started smoking like a year and a half ago. I didn't even smoke when we shot the movie. Like,
wow.
I never smoked the day before.
What made you start?
Honestly, I think I was pushing off the inevitable because I always liked the way weed smoked, and I always was embraced by the weed community.
Like
everybody used to think I smoked, but I never did. I was just high on life.
Yeah, and I hear you.
After a while, I was just like, you know what? This is, you know, I'm going to go ahead and smoke.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, one year, I was like, you know
it's
what?
Right.
I'm going to smoke this year. And I went to Div and I got so I outsmoked everybody.
Man, I call him Young Lung.
Yeah, for real.
His lungs are real young,
like,
and he outsmoked everybody.
Young.
Yeah.
And I'm trying to catch up with everybody. I done outsmoked everybody. I ain't met my match yet.
I'm telling you, Big, he ain't lying, man.
Besides that edible. That edible, you gotta watch yourself.
Yeah, that's a monster on that.
Oh, that put me
like
on
that
album,
you can't have nothing to do.
I was floating.
You definitely not going.
I remember being there at the premiere, but
yeah.
You sure conducted your business because I had some loose ends. You tighten those up, Jack.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Maybe you need to stay on them edible. Every time I answer the phone, he answers. He's like, "Yeah, Big, hold on a minute."
But I'm glad I would. People always ask me why I waited so late. But I'm glad I waited late because I know how to handle it now. I'm more mature. I'm responsible.
Right.
You know, I can still all this.
You're a little taller. Yep.
Yeah.
A little taller. I ain't had my growth spurt yet. So
right.
I'm
taller than you, Duvall.
I'm 5'4" and I'm 5'5" when I'm sleep because you grow taller.
Wow.
Come on. Your body stretch out. Yeah. Get that air in your vertebrae.
<know that.
laughs> And how tall are you, Louis?
5'4"
Yeah, I'm tall in Mexico.
Oh, we're going to have a short off.
I'm tall in Mexico.
Short off, brother.
Yeah,
in Mexico and in China, I am tall.
You're
just
ball.
Here.
Right.
Just here?
Yeah. I could play center in China.
Now, let me ask you this, Duvall, man. What did you do before comedy? Was there another way, like, and not nothing crazy, but you know what I'm saying? Like, if comedy money didn't kick in.
All I did was entertainment. And I was in Jacksonville doing what every street dude did.
I heard
you know
that.
What I'm saying? That's, shout out to Doc, man. Doc, yeah. Doc from my town. He know where I'm from. You know what I'm saying? So for me to just come from here, like I was thinking about that in the theater. Like I came from here, and now I'm right here with all the people I grew. I remember being in eighth grade going, sneaking, listening to, that's when you had the headphone, you sneaking in right here.
Yeah.
I remember listening to Doggy Style when it came out. You know what I'm saying? So now I'm here with the people. Like, the reason why I got into comedy was because of Friday.
Really, though? Wow.
Yeah. Like, I was like, I want, that's the movie, I want to do them type of movie. And I got into it, and now I'm doing the movie with this man.
Yeah, man.
I can retire right now and be good.
Don't do it now.
I'm not, because I'm holding it. Yeah. I'm not, but I'm saying, like, if this was all that happened.
You being premature now, man. Then you got to come back and be like, all right, I'm back. You know what I'm saying?
That's what comedians do.
Take all our gifts back
and
shit.
That's what comedians do. You know, we go crazy.
I think they do it for the gifts.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? All the accolades, my farewell tour.
I got to do my crazy part, because every comedian go crazy. So I'm going to go crazy eventually.
It's coming.
It's coming.
Eventually.
You can't be a legend unless you go crazy.
That is true. You got to get more of a story.
Come on.
You
got to go viral.
You got to have something for your unsung. You
know what that is true.
Come on.
That,
you can't have a great life.
Then you got to swing back.
Yeah,
yes.
You got to swing back.
You got to swing back.
You got to swing back. I haven't done yet. I haven't lost my fight. Right?
Yeah. You got to overcome.
Yeah, you definitely need that. You need a scandal.
Yeah.
Man, I don't even know if we use weed as your gateway. Do we go crack hair? No.
I'm thinking about coke. I'm thinking about coke. They look like they have a good time on coke. So I'm thinking about going to coke.
We started talking grow house.
It might be your spiral.
Yeah, that's what Grow House 3 going to be about, my coke addiction. Yeah, get me all coke back to weed.
Are you right?
Write that
man.
Up. Write that up.
Pooh mess around and give us the bomb first, then he don't be on the next ones.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, Pooh, you don't have no affiliation with any of the Fridays now?
You know what? Cube and I are working on Last Friday.
Yes.
I hope so, man.
Yeah, man.
Come on.
Yeah. I hope so.
Yeah, we on it. But at the first Friday, yeah, and but not next Friday or Friday afternoon.
Man, see, I saw Bye Felicia.
Mm-hmm.
I saw Miss Parker last night. And those kind of things, man, that's like staples. You know what I'm saying? Like,
common word.
Oh, man.
Bye Felicia.
Bye Felicia. Yeah, and she can walk in somewhere.
Bye Felicia or something. On the internet, on TV or something.
She can walk in somewhere and people probably don't even know like that's her.
They don't even know like where that comes from.
Yeah,
some people.
Bye Felicia.
Like, Bye Felicia.
DJ Pooh, man. Enjoyed the movie. Written and directed by you.
Bro. Yes, sir.
What is in your head, bro?
Smoke.
Man, really though. So, Pooh, you do smoke.
Absolutely.
I heard that. Yeah. Always? Had you always been a...
No bout or doubt it.
Damn, I heard that. Man, because something like Duvall, he said he a year and a half. You know what I'm saying? I have yet to first blow any smoke myself.
Really?
Yeah, man. And they gave me a parting swag bag on the way out. And I was like, man, what am I going
to
do with this?
It is a blessing to smoke. Let me tell you.
Stop it, Duval.
I used to be you.
Really?
Yeah.
I used to be you.
Oh, my gosh.
Tell me.
What are your smoking blessings?
Thank you, Eminem role model.
Think about it. You can't
peer
die
pressure,
from
big.
It.
Peer pressure.
You can't die from it. Nobody has never died.
Ain't nobody ever OD'd.
Well, we don't know.
No, you can't die.
Nobody never OD'd.
No case.
Nope.
There's no case.
Think about it.
You tried to
die. I have too. Like you can die from cigarettes.
Right. Yeah, okay.
Plenty of people die from cigarettes, but nobody's died from it. Everybody's actually has brought crime down in Denver. It's proof.
Right.
Damn. Yeah.
You a year and a half in,
and now I'm a preacher
all the
for
research.
It. I'm the Martin Luther King of weed.
We shall always
smoke,
man.
Smoke.
Man, what does the blooper reel look like?
Oh my goodness.
Oh yeah. They showed pieces of it.
Yeah, I saw it, man. It just seemed like it would have been so much fun shooting this movie.
Man.
But then also you gotta get the movie done.
Yeah.
So at some point you gotta stop being homie and laughing and be DJ Pooh the director.
That's what he was.
It was a lot few times in there where you know we got a chance to know each other.
Yeah, right. Yeah. He told me straight up a couple times.
Yeah, like, dude,
man,
like, you know,
when, yeah, when
this
they
is
don't
on my
blank,
credit card now,
yeah, when
bro.
They don't blink, they serious.
Yeah, when they don't blink their eyes, like, man.
Yeah, he was like, bro.
Man, your eyes turn dry, yeah, bro. Like, nah.
But I kept messing up on them lines.
But I got to say, Duvall came to work, though.
I heard
brother
that.
Brother came to work, you know what I'm saying? I got to give him that, man.
Yeah, man.
And when it came down to promoting the movie, nobody got down like Duvall.
Yeah, man. When I saw him last night, I was like, man, Pooh coming in tomorrow. He was like, yeah, I'll come tomorrow. Yeah. I'm like, go ahead with your, and I'm thinking, you know, after party, and you know, I know y'all had an extremely long day.
And Pooh ain't have to do this, but he gave me a piece of the pie too.
Yeah,
did you know that?
Absolutely, man.
Yeah, he did.
Like the pie of,
he have
budget,
to do that.
Like the pie of money, or like a piece of like just
a
pie.
Piece, a piece of the film, man. I took this film and tried to make a model of saying, you know, it's a company, and everybody that's involved in this company is going to have a piece of the company.
I heard
that.
And it's an independent film, so I was able to actually do that and not take us in and get us all ripped off and just, you know.
Damn.
And I would have did it even if he wouldn't have did that, real talk. But he did.
So
that
he's
just
marketing his film, too. That's why he doing all the marketing.
Yeah.
And he ain't working for me.
That's
some money.
That's why he got up. It wasn't just the love of poop.
Now, I needed to work for real because I don't want them, because you know them trolls on the internet be like, what happened?
Yeah.
Oh, you only did so. That's why I did it. It wasn't even about the money for
real.
Right,
hell
yeah. Looking crazy.
Like, man, I don't want nobody talking all this mess.
Hell no.
Man, yes. So yeah, we got to give it a great box office, like a great weekend, man.
Yeah, that's what it's really about, man. That first weekend is so
weekend,
important,
man.
Especially with black films and stuff too, man. It's really important that first weekend to go and see it, man. Hopefully everybody go see it. One thing I could promise, you may laugh and you may learn how to grow. You get something out of it. Yeah.
Yeah.
And you know what, man, for what you told me what the budget was, you know, we've seen some movies, man, where I say we see, like, the mic hanging in.
See the mic hanging in.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, the boom mic, or you'll see, like, the sound get crazy. Or, you know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. Or you'll see, like, a bruise switch to the other side of somebody's face for continuity. It's like, man, we got to roll with it.
Yeah.
This looks good.
Yeah. Man, thank you, Big.
So funny.
I'm proud of this little film, man. And, you know, I've learned how to do a lot with a little. I ain't saying I don't want to do a bigger budget movie.
Yeah.
But I've learned how to do it.
He's saying, if I could do this with this, just imagine what I could do with that.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm batting 100%, so I'm proud of that. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, hell yeah, you are. Hell yeah, you are.
Undefeated.
This definitely not going to be. Everybody is smoking right now or doing something, brother.
Sure,
this is another. This is like a cult classic right here.
And to get a film out on 420 that starts at 420 in theaters, like, let's go ahead and retire now.
I'm ready.
Yo.
Well, I'm not, so let's finish up the interview.
Yeah, yeah.
They remind me all the time what my contract looked like.
Hey, man,
all the commercials I
got
to bring
too,
on.
Big Boy, I want to shout you out too, man, because I remember about 12 years ago, like, I mean, I had just started doing comedy and stuff. He was one of the first people outside of Florida, the South, that was like, hey, man, you funny in the mug.
Yeah,
man. I want you to come to my show, do an interview. Nobody, like, this was a nationally syndicated guy. Like, he was already popping. And he showed me love. So the fact that he did that, it takes, I mean, a lot of people don't see stuff, you know, but he saw it. So I want to thank you, man.
Nah, thank you, brother. No, and I'm telling you, man, it was one that Cedric.
Cedric Entertainer starting lineup.
Oh,
shout out to Cedric.
Oh, man. I would watch your part over and over. I even took the song, the music song that you did, and I even put that in my phone just so I can hear it at my leisure. And then from there, bro, it's like you see cats, you're like, oh, what was it? The name wasn't even Lil Duval back then.
Yeah, it was my real name.
Yeah.
I was going by my real name, Roland.
Yeah.
Hey.
Yeah. So
what's your name?
My name is Lil Rose.
Yeah.
I went to Duval to represent for my city. So when I can't, because that's what we go by in Florida, by the counties, like Duval County, Dade County. So I was like, I can rep my city even when I don't say it. So I got everybody in the world saying Duval, and they don't even realize, you know what I'm saying?
Man.
So it's kind of like inspiration from where I'm from too. You know what I'm
saying? But to watch your career also, and you know what I love about it too, is there's no expiration date. It seemed like it's just getting better and better and relevant. You know what I'm saying? And then when you pop up and if I see you on MTV or I see you on the show, I'll follow you on social media.
Yeah.
Like this movie, to see you in the movie, it was a no-brainer.
Stepping stone. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And you could see where cats are like your work ethic also, bro.
I think Duval going to blow up after this movie. I told him this morning that he probably going to answer
gonna
my call.
Which
was
special.
He already know that ain't going to happen.
Right.
He already know that ain't
going to
happen.
Hold him.
Uh-huh. He going to start speaking with a British accent.
He already know I'm loyal to him to the death.
Like, call in for this.
I'm just that type of guy, you know?
Yeah, same thing my homeboy Frankie told me.
Nah, I'm dead serious. I show better than I can tell. You know what I'm saying? I can show you. Yeah, I'm loyal to a default sometimes. But like, I mean, loyal to this. I come, like I said, you brought me here. You brought me in with a bunch of other comedians. I tore their ass up.
Hello.
Like, it was Jonah. We were ranking on each other.
Oh, man, yeah. I brought him to the neighborhood one time. I don't want to say the person's name because it really hurt his feelings.
Yeah, man.
But We had a cat that would come in, and we did a thing called O Session. And this is like, this right here is like the crown.
The O Session crown, bro.
It's dusty.
As you can see, we haven't had an O Session in a minute.
I think Duval's the one who had it at the end.
Yeah, it's really mine. You hung your hat up on that one. But let me tell you, man, so we had a dude that was like the king of O Sessions. Mm-hmm. And so he knew Duval was coming in. So he was like, man, I got to get him. Lil Duval never knew that we did this thing called O Session. So my guy comes like in and he's ready. Like he's, you know, and he and I'm talking about disrespectfully ready. I'm ready to tear this dude apart. I'm ready to do this, do that, right? So we get in there and he's sitting in there like, you know.
Yeah.
So Duval talking. And so then it's like, all right, well, you know. So I tell Lil Duval, I'm like, man, this is what we do the O Session. And I mean, it was totally like,
boom, boom,
like,
boom.
Yeah, he was ambushed.
Yep.
Just like, all right, okay, now what is it again? What is it? All right. And I'm like, man, you just guys go back and forth. Yeah.
Wow.
Like, really, really, for real, he was ambushed. So he had to do it. So my boy go in on him. Go in. And man, it was bad. Dude, yeah.
You came out spraying.
Man,
Street sweepers.
We jumping over pool tables and everything, boom. Bad. And to the point, like, we recording it, right? And so now my dude, he know the routine. Like, hey, man, you know you got to keep it clean. So now he's like, no, fuck this shit, motherfucker, fuck this.
Wow.
Like, so we can't use the audio. We're like, we got it.
No, we got what we need.
And so then when it was over, he was like, man, I can't believe y'all did that too. I was like, hold on, man. He thought we, I was like, no, I said, we ambushed him.
Yeah.
I said, man, he didn't know what was, he thought that for the longest.
Yeah.
Not at all.
That was
not
a classic moment.
Man, he said something about my guy's sweater.
I don't even remember what I said.
But when he said that, you know how your instinct take over? Like, he probably shouldn't have looked down at his shirt, but when he said something about his shirt, he looked down and it was like, oh, it's too late, bro.
The key to getting people is their insecurity. Like, I don't have no insecurity, so no matter what you done said, I done heard it before, I done thought of, like, I already know who I am, so it don't bother me. But most people have an insecurity, and I tell on that.
That's what I was going to ask you. Nobody on social media has ever got to you?
No, I've never. Like, if I showed y'all some of my DMs, I get death threats. I get everything. And rest in peace, Charlie Murphy. They was like, why they took Charlie Murphy and left Duval here?
Damn.
I get those type of stuff.
I didn't even think you saw that when I sent that
out. Oh, you sent that?
Damn, man.
And it's crazy because you're really trolling because I didn't even put at Lil Duval.
Dog, please read some more.
I just threw it out there.
How'd he find that?
Man, this dude, you got a team. If it ain't you.
It's all me. I search my name.
You got an excellent team talking about me, man.
But like, I get a lot of that stuff, but it never bothered me because like, I never understood cyberbullying. Mm. Like, it's because like, we are on the internet. You can't beat me up.
That's true.
Like, I never understood how people got in their feelings like that because it's never been, because where I came up, that's all we did was rank.
You know what I'm saying? I can tell when you came to the show that one time.
That's all we did. Like, people were scared to come in the room. Like, I used to be in with all the, everybody that I went to school with went in the NFL. But I used to rank on all of them. All of them. I used to be the rank
king. When did you know it was comedy for you, Lil Duval? And you can make a living.
When I saw Friday. When I saw Friday, and then I saw Chris Tucker on Def Comedy Jam, and I was so that's how you do it. You do stand-up. And you get in movies.
Had you ever did stand-up before? Like, what was your stand-up early on?
I first started doing stand-up in Atlanta. I didn't do it in Jacksonville. I moved to Atlanta, and I was still doing the street thing or whatever. And then I started, my man, he was like, man, you got to do stand-up and do this, that, whatever. I went up to Chris Tucker Comedy Club, and they didn't call my name. So, like, 2 years
so
later.
It's like open mic night where you just sign up and go
for free. I just signed
free.
My first time going to comedy club. That was my first time going on stage. And I thought, I didn't even know how it worked. When I got off stage, I was like, so what we do now? I thought I was famous then. I thought that's how it worked.
Oh, man.
Yeah, okay. I didn't know.
Am I going on tour?
Yeah, I didn't know what was going on. So that's how it started. And I started snowballing. I mean, started snowballing to what it is now.
Do you use your social media a lot? Because I see cats now, man, like Michael Blackson, Marlon Wayne. Like, I follow a lot of cats on. And these cats, y'all always working.
Yeah.
And some people, if you didn't have social media, you wouldn't know how much cats are really out.
Comedians. Like, think about somebody like Bruce. You haven't seen him on TV in probably about 15, 20, but he's still on the road selling out. That's the good thing about being a comedian. Rappers, they only got like a football career, like 2 years, 3 years.
Yeah, if you're lucky.
Yeah. Damn. Yeah. Well, with comedians, we get better with time. Like, the longer I'm up, the bigger I get. So it's a win-win for us. We can't lose.
Grow House in theaters right now, man. Lil Duval in the neighborhood, man. DJ Pooh, the hip-hop gangster.
Yo, yeah. Pooh, and after the movie, when we were watching it, I know Big Lobster. Oh,
what's
whatever.
That? You remember that handle,
oh,
huh?
Oh, my God, man. Cool DJ Pooh, the hip-hop gangster. Man, oh, hell
man,
yeah.
Man, that take was my back. First mixtape,
man. That was my joints, boy. Man, that stopped.
Rodian swap me.
I want to show you a scratch I invented, man, perfected. I know you can't front. And hey. Tell me that you heard it in Philly. Silly, you. Dumb hillbilly. I make the beats for Spade and KMT. Go ahead now.
That's
go ahead, Lou.
Oh, like I was saying, I know me and Big kind of stayed behind it and seen all the credits, and I love how at the
oh
end.
Oh, my God,
it said,
man.
Did you read the big one in bold?
Which
that
one?
That said for the haters?
Yes. Yes.
Was there a lot of haters
it
while you were making
be.
This movie?
It was, man. Yeah. Unfortunately, it's always the haters out there, man, and the naysayers. Mm-hmm. Out there, man, and as I said, it was a mission.
You made sure you put that in big ass bold letters too.
He had real haters, real haters.
You know what's crazy about that, man?
Why?
Pooh is Pooh.
I'm talking about big haters. I ain't talking about like
company haters and
super. I am not. Never mind.
Nah, damn. I got you.
Yeah,
yeah.
Damn.
But in the end, though, that it's nothing new. You know what I'm saying? It's nothing new.
People, you'd be like, dang, he was hating.
That's when you know you're doing something.
Like famous haters?
Yes.
Wow. Okay, we leave it right there.
Yeah, leave it at that.
Yeah, I don't want to start. Yeah, don't say it. Write it down. I'll say it.
Now, I just want to let y'all know the magnitude of what we overcame, though.
Yeah, hey, man, let me tell you what my joint is, too, man, Duval. Hit him with the shoulders.
Hey. Kill him with the shoulders.
Kill him with the shoulders. That's a hit record, man. Fuzz sent that to me. Yeah. Fuzz was like, man, Big, please look at this.
Yeah.
I came back trying to break that on radio.
That on
oh, my God,
it's on the soundtrack.
Man. And what's the video that we ended out with? It was, what was the grown ass gangster.
It was Knick Knack, right?
Man, but my thing, man, that hit him with the shoulders.
Yeah.
That's man, that's a joint right there, man.
I got another song called Dropping Dick Off. I really do. Who followed me on social media? It's for all the fellas. It was real big for Valentine's Day.
I heard that.
But it's a song. It's on iTunes. You can pick it up on iTunes.
And I will. And you got my numbers now, man.
I promise.
When you come with anything like that, bro, use us as a vehicle, man.
Y'all think I'm playing? Hold on, let me find my
and it's called dropping dick off.
Dropping dick off.
That's all you need, right
dropping
there, man.
Dropping dick off. It's for the culture.
Yeah.
It's for the culture.
Let's do it for
you. Think I'm playing?
Man, hold on. Let me see this.
You think I'm? Put your glasses on.
Yeah, it's on iTunes.
You connected?
Get it on iTunes.
It's on iTunes.
Drop it off.
Yeah.
Do you have it in there? Can we play this one right
here? Yeah. Well, not clean. It ain't clean.
Man, just plug it in. Let me hear a little bit of it.
Yeah, plug it in. Let me hear.
Plug it in, man.
Oh, here, you're going to need this extension.
I would think that dropping dick off can't be too clean, right?
Yeah, you need the extension.
I
was going to make it clean, but I said I'm going to keep it for the culture.
Yeah, you know what I'm
you
saying?
You know what I'm saying? Keep it. Because I used to hate when people used to make clean songs.
Everything can't be clean.
Yeah, everything can't be clean.
And then what
do
they call? Dropping package off?
Yeah, that's like making a clean. Like, why would you want to see a clean porno?
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
It doesn't make it a porno.
Lord knows I used to try to watch him, though.
The
you know what I'm saying? Yeah,
you get what you can get.
Yeah, Porky's. You, know, you watch Porky's.
Oh,
that's
a
clean,
man. Yeah.
That's a clean porno.
And those were coming out right when I was exploring myself.
Hey, turn it up.
All righty, hold on.
Uh-oh.
Oh, you did that one.
I'm dropping dick off. I'm dropping dick off. I'm dropping dick off. I'm dropping dick off. Oh, I'm dropping dick off. 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 I'm dropping dick off.
You feel it in your soul, don't you? You feel it?
Go ahead, man. Hey, man. You be making songs, though.
Hey, here's
up. No, he didn't flick his lighter up in this video.
He did.
You made too many R&B shows.
Yeah. I'm putting out an R&B album.
I miss R&B.
Man, well, I think we found the savior.
Yeah, come on.
Come on.
Right. I'm putting out that love back.
Please don't pump him up.
No, I'm putting out a comedy album. It's going to be called Laugh Now, Sing Later.
I like that.
Come on, now.
Duvall can actually sing, man.
Don't keep saying that, though.
I'm dead serious.
I know, but I'm already about to take it.
No, that copyrighted right there is live on camera, so when they do, I can use this and sue your ass.
Those are our cameras.
Right, we don't give you the material.
We got a camera back there.
He recording. Not that part. Look, he talking. He typing to me. He handling the business. Yeah, now I'm going to act like we never said it.
Lord.
Hey, man, you ever thought about like naming it like Laugh Now, Sing Later?
Laugh now, sing later. What did I say before?
Or what about sing now, laugh later? Like one of those where you
doing... Nigga, I just said that. The hell?
One of
you
those where you...
stole mine and gave it back.
One of those, man, where you singing and doing comedy.
Yeah,
like
yeah, that's
album.
What I'm saying. Laugh now, sing later.
Yeah, like that.
Yeah, what I said before.
But either or. No, you like, you should do that.
Yeah, that's what I want to do. That's going to be a
take
career.
Take it, man. It's yours.
Man, that's mine already. You're confusing me. You're a smart. You're a reverse psychologist. You know I got a Florida education, man.
Man, but nah, that's why I love the direction you going, man. But if you should do an album because your voice.
Yeah.
You should do an album. Hit it with the shoulders. Put all that on there, man. But it's and also some comedy.
I am. I'm going to do
Laugh Now, Sing Later.
It's going to be like. I want to make it. That's why I want to do with my special. I want to intertwine it into one.
You should do a special where you intertwine it into one as well.
That ain't a bad idea.
I see what you're doing. You editing your part. Oh, you good.
Nah,
baby, I like your idea better.
Thank
though.
You, brother. Thank you. I appreciate that, man. Thank you, man.
I wrote Grow House.
You did?
Oh, wait
did
a minute.
That's dope as hell.
Oh, look at him.
We didn't go on too far.
Hey, yeah. Too far.
What else you working on, man? Like, I know you got to have something in your head, bro.
Yeah, man. I got a couple things I'm working on. I got another film that I'm getting ready to go into right now called Ramped Up. It's a skate film.
Dope.
And and so I'm working on that now. And
I gotta learn how to skate.
Cool. Yeah, you know what I'm saying.
I'm saying. Yeah.
And he said so. He know I can't do it.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying.
I will learn.
That was one of those where. You don't even, you know you don't have a part
yeah,
in it.
Yeah, yeah,
you
yeah. You
know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I got a bodybuilding movie.
There's something in there for you, though. Man. Right, it's something that I really want to do. My son is a skater, and
really
it inspired
though.
Me to do it, yeah.
Are you going to put your son in it?
Yeah, definitely.
Heard that. Yeah, definitely. You might as well, huh?
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Like, man.
That's what the white folks do.
Yeah, he's the one who turned me on to the whole thing.
That's why.
You know, and plus your kids will work, you know, they owe you.
Keep it in the house.
Hell yeah. Like,
that
man.
Money back.
Yeah.
Get them money to take care of you when you get older.
Yeah, how old is your son, Pooh?
I'm doing that. He's 20.
I heard that, man.
So
how many kids you have, Pooh?
For a while, man. Five.
I heard that. Yeah, man. Hip hop, huh?
I got one.
How old is your kid?
Nine.
A boy
9 years
or girl?
Old, a girl.
Does she know that Lil Duval is like her dad though? Like,
yeah,
no,
she
knows
older than
him. Nah, she does.
I was gonna ask.
She be on my back. I put it on my Instagram. Her feet be dragging the floor almost.
Shut up, man.
Yeah,
I can see that.
It's true. I got it on my Instagram, but like, man, she 9 and it's kind of messing me up because like. She growing titties now, bro.
Oh, my God.
That just towed me up. Like, my daughter growing titties.
All right, Trump.
Yeah, wow. I know.
No, I'm serious. Like,
you see the room, everybody got a little uncomfortable. Like
when
well,
your daughter grows titties, it messes you up. Like, you see your... I'm used to seeing a baby. Now she growing titties and hair under arms. I'm like, oh, Lord.
Yeah, my son, came downstairs. Right? And he was like, Dad, he was like, look, I'm getting hair. And I'm like, oh.
Really?
Hey,
oh, he
women
he
don't understand that, but for a man.
Oh, man. Is,
like, when you first get your hair, I mean, when I first got my nut hairs, I had my pants
when you got
down.
What?
My nut hairs. My pubic hair.
You didn't get nut hair?
You didn't get pubic
not
hair?
Just the way.
Oh, okay.
Like, when I first got my pubic hair, you wanted everybody to see it. You had your pants sagging, your boxers sagging.
Yeah, man. Tugging on it.
Yeah, tugging
see,
on
I,
it.
I was always fat, so I had to pull my stomach up. Be like, man, look at this right here. Look at this. Surprise. Surprise to you. Grow House. Make sure you guys check it out, man.
Yeah.
DJ Pooh, writer, director, everything.
Check it
Lil
out.
Lil Duval, star of the movie, the feature
I'm
film.
I'm tripping off. Y'all have the about. First sound effects before they had technology. Really
oh, the bell?
Yeah.
Man, I always
that
hear
bell
it, so
been
I got
with me for
it.
Over
yeah.
20 years, bro.
Yeah. I had
you
to do that.
You can
tell
it.
Yeah.
Man.
Yeah, that's the original bell right there.
You know
there.
They got a button now for that.
I don't want that button.
Okay.
Yeah, nah, man.
Nah,
keep a G in there.
That's authentic
in
there, man.
That looked like a slave bell, for real. Like,
it
you
is.
Look like you got Harriet Tubman people when they was growing
wow.
up.
That's the one. You know what I'm saying?
Underground Railroad bell.
Hell yeah.
Underground Railroad bell.
Y'all better hurry up now.
Master know you ringing bells.
And then what I did one of those, well, I'm going to take this bell.
Yeah, that's going with at me.
I showed them.
Yeah.
I showed them.
Yeah.
Make sure that engineering comes. All this fiber done fell all over here. Yeah. This board ain't gonna work. You know what I'm saying? Well, I'm gonna wrap up this interview, ladies and gentlemen. No, I definitely wanna thank y'all for coming into the neighborhood, man.
Make sure y'all see Grow House.
Make sure you guys go check it out, man. Treat yourself, don't cheat yourself. Lil Duval, always a pleasure to have you in the neighborhood. Pooh, thank you for coming back to the neighborhood, man. And I appreciate
y'all. Respect the legend. This is a legend for real.
Yeah,
all you young
DJ Pooh, come on, man. Come on. There it is right there, big boy neighborhood.